In the last video, I had another brain-dead moment, and I couldn't remember where Yahweh recorded in his word that he gave you over to statutes and to boundaries and judgments and such that wouldn't give you life because you didn't do his boundaries and his judgments. So I was just brain-dead, and I mumbled, maybe it was Ezekiel 25 or 26. And anyway, when I got done recording the video, I was kind of popped myself on the head. I was like, duh, it's chapter 20. But anyway, pretty key concept, because that's the lies of Christianity that he gave you over to believe into. And it's just reality. So it's a reality that the rest of the testimony of his word backs up. So the title of this video was the 38-day death sentence. In the first Exodus, which was a foreshadow of the Exodus that's at hand, our Maker, after the 335 days of his cloud, was on the mountain, on his holy mountain, which ties into from the 12 chapters of the 8th month to the chapters 18 through 19 of his End Time Son of Adam prophecy. Oddly enough, there's 335 days to take us to that chapter 20. That was the first chapter of yesterday's assembly. That's where he had brought us to, actually. And it's a chronological order of going through his word. So it was a coincidence, I'm sure, that we were in chapter 20, yesterday's assembly. The timing of yesterday's assembly is amazing. But 335 days later, so just like with the situation with the first Exodus. But anyway, they went on their 11-day journey, according to These Are the Truths, chapter 1. And, of course, that's a prophecy, because during that there was Miriam 7 days, and all sorts of stuff happened. Anyway, so the 11 days is the prophecy for this 11th year that we're in from these videos. So anyway, and other 11s that he's woven into this. But the think of 11-minute space flight this morning is what it's scheduled to be with, though, the so-called richest man in the world. The richest man in the world stand for your faces, but the so-called richest man in the world reaching up like the Tower of Babel, like happened 9 days earlier with another rich man. Obviously, he's the third richest. Bezos is the third richest man in the world, because the wife and I fled in the wilderness are by far the two richest. But anyway, he skyrocketed up, I guess, 65 miles of all things. I glanced at the story, but I'm not sure how long it lasted. It was scheduled to last 11 minutes. Tower of Babylon, got to reach up to the dual heavens, you know. Anyway, the flights, especially the earlier one with Branson, it's just remarkable how it ties into our Maker's word. But that's another subject. But anyway, they had their 11 days journey, and they sent out the spies to 411 for Operation Grapes of Wrath upon Lebanon, aka the White Mountain, in 1996. But they went up, they sent out the 12 spies for the 40 days and 40 nights. Got to be careful here, and I got my mind's racing. But anyway, and that brought it to 301, and which is the waters of the first waters of Meribah waypoint a year earlier. Anyway, and they didn't go up except two of them, Caleb and Yeshua, Joshua. They said that we could go up and take it, but because they believed Yahweh and trusted him. But except for two of them, there's two of us, trusted Yahweh, and the rest of them didn't. And then Yahweh cut them off and sentenced them to die over the next 38 years in the wilderness. And this is the time of the Exodus. And after today, there's 38 days that remain to 724, that 1260th day. That's also the 1435th day and the 1335th. And I'll get into that, because the reduplication of the 1260 with the 1085 day overlap or the 175 day offset for the Alcoholics Anonymous AA Abraham's 175 years and Strong's number 175 for Aaron, his high priest. But things I've talked about in other videos, but because you're drunk off the wine and your fornication to our Maker. But anyway, amazing, 1260 days to bring forth the man child, and how he's woven this in there, and how it's actually 1335 days from the Virgin of the Sky sign, and 1435 days from the Virgin of the Sky sign, And how that ties into the translation of the 1335 is amazing too. But I don't want to get into it. I want to keep this video short. And I mean, I could get into so much stuff, to so many things about tonight's beginning of the 289 million plummet, which took 290 days for Joab to number Israel for the slaughter. But these 38 days, I believe that Yahweh has funneled. Because, of course, from the year 6,000 years, the ram's horn released the debts. There's 38 years left. We're in that year. You have the year 6,000, the year 6,001, and we're in the year. We're in that 38 years left of the 40 years of his end time Son of Adam prophecy. So, but I believe it's going to be dynamic. I believe that 2/3 of the world are going to die in these next 38 days. I really do. And then after that, he's going to send a sword after the other third, and a tithe of that third will live through this. 3.3, repeating 3%. But 38 days left, 2/3 of the world being slaughtered during this time. Everybody's so worried about the circumcision 19. In America anyway, the controversy going on with the circumcision 19 band-aid, if you will. Yahweh's your only band-aid, and none of that's going to matter whether you got the band-aid or not got the band-aid. Of course, obviously, we need to turn to him for all of our medical reasons, but the point is none of that's going to matter. The circumcision 19 virus he sent to mirror the time he caused the fourth conception of the Emmanuel man-child, Meher Shalal Kushbaz, that's going to be born in the world 38 days from today. That's just amazing. And Isaiah 66 says, before this child's cord goes forth, he's going to make good on his reward to his enemies before he's going to begin to beforehand. So that means in the next 38 days, that 2/3 of the world are going to be destroyed. And then he's going to send the sword out after the other third. Folks, this is amazing. In his signature ring, in his Man of the Feast, a.k.a. Haggai, he says that part of that Isaiah 55 signature ring, but in chapter, with the 24th day of the ninth month, in chapter 2 of his Man of the Feast, what Haggai means, he says that he's part of the signature ring he sends me with, and the signature ring is obviously summed up, as I've said throughout these videos, by Isaiah 55:11. But he says that brother's going to be killing brother. Do you read the news? It's become so normal that it's just listed down in the stories. I mean, two or three killed here, there, and there. And it started when he sent me to Greece back in 2010. I mean, fathers killing their families and stuff. It just started happening. And then it was a big deal. It was reported a lot. And now it's increased. Believe me, it's not these 38 days. I believe it's going to see a huge increase of it. You got Russia threatening America today in the headlines. You have China in the last couple of days threatening Japan, American's ally, to nuke them. But brother killing another, that's been increasing, but still held back. It's been still small, but it's crazy. I mean, it's the amount of murders, and it's just random places and random. I mean, you read the stories, and it's just like, what caused? I mean, yesterday the wife that's fled in the wilderness to bring forth the man child Meher Shalal Kushbaz and his three siblings. She was telling me about a guy called, I guess that was even in Arizona or something. He called up the paramedics or something and shot him when they came and. Then he called up the fire department, went home, called up the fire department, not way, and shot them. Then they called police and shot a couple of them or something. I don't know. I didn't read the story. I should go on second hand. But I mean, it's just crazy, the amount of killing going on. And where is Zerubbabel? Zerubbabel, this is Yahweh's words upon Zerubbabel, not by might, not by power, but by his spirit, says Yahweh of hosts, in Zechariah chapter 4. And Haggai, aka the man of the feast, he's going to put a signature ring upon me. So when he sent me his signet ring, and it's going to include brother killing a brother with each other with a sword. And of course, I've said throughout these videos, ultimately that's symbolic of you teaching one another your lies, that patting each other on the back if they skip merrily along on the pathway that's going to cause them to be burnt up in a lake that burns with fire and brimstone. Teaching each other the lies of Christianity, your children, going to cause them to get burnt up. each man killing his brother and his children, offering your children up. And Yahweh says, even in the testimony of his word, in a few places even, they're supposed to be his children. We're supposed to be, even in yesterday's assembly, in chapters, we read chapters 20 through, excuse me, yeah, chapters 20 through 31 yesterday. And it even somewhere along in lines in there, it even talks about, they're my children, he says. They're supposed to be, supposed to bring children to him. Instead, you brought forth children to your father Satan, offering them up to the fire, he says. You offered my children up to the fire. Wow, Moloch, tying into December 25th, the Christmas celebration, the blasphemous Christmas celebration. Folks, this is real. It took 290 days for Joab and company to number Israel for the slaughter with that that threshing floor prophecy. Today's video is video number 1758. Look it up. Threshing means to thresh. Folks, wow, the threshing is getting ready to begin. It's getting ready to begin. And I believe you're going to see an increase in these next 38 days because he'll, I mean, his long suffering, which is it's translated long suffering, but it's drawn out dual nostrils, is mind boggling. How he kept extending his hand. He kept, and that's in the testimony where he kept extending his hand, saying, come out to be his people, but you wouldn't. And now comes, he's going to say, don't come up to his holy mountain. And you're going to want to come up anyway, and he's going to chase you like bees do. And it's just like then. But wow. 38-day death sentence. And of course, then we still have the rest of these 38 years of to follow of Ezekiel. But wow, of him whittling it down to a final tithe, I believe, is how it's going to work. But wow, about 2/3 of the world. And then you have 38 years of, you got in these 38 days, then you have 38 special, I guess you should say. And that's how many people are going to get shot today with a 38 special. I mean, in this Elohim forsaking planet. That you were too worried about, do we get the circumcision 19 band-aid or not? Wow, we do. If we do, of course, and then we are relying on mankind for your deliverance. And if you don't, of course, statistics are you're going to die. But the reality is you're going to die if you don't turn back to him through that which he's restored, and come out from your whoredoms to him. From playing the whore to him, loving and worshiping your make-believe images of him and his son, you're going to die. It's just reality. I don't know how much more serious this could be. Your children are going to die if they don't come out. And of course, some of them, your children are old enough to make the decision on their own, but some of them are under the age of accountability, and it's your responsibility to come out and show them, children, this is the way. Walk you in it. That straight and narrow pathway called the testimony of Yahweh, my Elohim's word. That Yeshua said, few people find the straight and narrow pathway. Straight is the gate. It's never the pathway. Narrow is the gate. What part of that's too difficult for you to understand? Boy, his almighty blinders and his almighty earplugs indeed are almighty. And you're getting ready to see, so is his arm.